This is a what?
And this is a rebellious people.
being rebellious across says in the book of Samuel, it says rebellious is next to what? Witchcraft. When you rebel against the Lord, it's next to witchcraft. That's why it's not a coincidence we're in Hollywood right now. Hollywood, like the brother was breaking down earlier, pretending to sorcery and witchcraft. Right? You're confusing the people, man. Right? Drop that. Let me get Galatians chapter 3, verse 4. Let me get Romans chapter 15, verse 4. Bring it up. This is the book of Romans, chapter 15, verse 4. For whatsoever things you were written aforetime were written for our learning, that we through patience and comfort of the scriptures might have hope. So this Bible is a book of history and prophecies, past, present, and future. We know what happened in the past. That's why we're learning from the mistakes of the past, so we can correct ourselves in the future, in the present time that we're in. Right? We know.
Galatians chapter 3 verse 1. All foolish Galatians, who have bewitched
you?
The Lord said? Who have bewitched
you? The Lord
said? Who have bewitched you?
And that's what's happening right now in Hollywood. A lot of people want to be idol worship. They want to worship man and woman instead of worship the Most High God. So now the Lord does what? You want to worship a damn celebrity? The Most High kills that celebrity. If you ain't giving credit to the Most High, Yahweh Shemel Shai, then the Lord's going to kill that celebrity to show you that what? You got to be there.
I'm a celebrity.
You a celebrity?
Yeah, my name is Adele.
All right, I'll put it. You can be a celebrity when you want. The real stars are the Israelites. The real stars are the Israelites. You can be a damn celebrity all you want. That's why the Lord said in the book of Revelation, the stars of heaven have fallen. What is that speaking about? Every star you see on the floor, like Christ said, he's going to bring out the damn star out of the floor and root them out. Everything that's built on this wicked land is going to be broken down. You can lie for you want. You think it's a game. Drop that. Let me get on Psalms chapter 2, verse 4. This ain't no damn comedy show. This is thus saith the Lord. Hold on, Mr. Celebrity. Bring it out.
This is the book of Psalms. Chapter 2, verse 4. He that sitteth in the heavens shall laugh.
You know what I'm
saying? He that sitteth in the heavens shall laugh.
You think it's a comedy show?
He that sitteth in the heavens shall laugh.
So guess what? The children of Israel are going to get the last laugh. We're going to get the last laugh. Because like the saying goes, revenge is the bitch that shows what? Cold. And the Most High about to be cold blood. But in the meantime, the Lord is heating up the earth right now. Let me get Isaiah 29, verse 6. The Lord is heating up the earth right now. She want to talk about, she wants the mic. We got the mic right now. Let me get Jeremiah chapter 5, verse 14. This is the mic that you're going to get. Bring it up.
This is the book of Isaiah, chapter 29, verse 6. Thou shalt be visited of Jehovah of hosts with thunder.
What?
With thunder.
With what?
With thunder.
Like your brother was saying, that thunder is the one that started the fire. Like it happened in Florida, a thunder strike and a lightning strike hit that building and it collapsed. That's thunder of the Most High God. There was a thunder strike in India in 76 India. That's of the Most High. You know?
And with earthquake.
And what?
And with earthquake.
There was an earthquake in Haiti today. There was an earthquake in Panama last week. So many earthquakes that we're seeing all over the world. Why? Because God is about to visit this world. This world is in trouble. This world is in trouble. And the only one that's going to be saved are the Hebrew Israelites, which are the blacks and Spanish Americans. The rest of you Caucasians got guns. That's why you had a damn cracker last week jumping the top of a damn building.
That's right.
Swung to a bomb like a damn WWE star. You want to talk that nigga was Jeff Hardy being funny this man. You know what?
With storm and tempest.
What?
With storm and tempest.
And they had a hurricane in New York 2 weeks ago. You had a hurricane that was called Hurricane Isaiah. The head Atlantic City. All these elements, the Most High is coming to the earth. Because what? Judgment is coming to this place. They don't want to worship idols, the Most High is dragging them down. Bring it out.
In the flame of devouring fire.
In the what?
In the flame of devouring fire.
What happened in California right now?
Flame of devouring fire.
What's happening to the whole West Coast?
Flame of devouring fire.
This is in the Bible. This is the book that they say that is a fairy tale. It's fake. But you know what's funny about the Bible? People is quick to believe movies, especially being in Hollywood. They want to believe movies, but what is that? The white man literally took and stole from the Bible.
Right.
Every movie, think about the white man took from his Bible.
That's right.
The white man took from his Bible. That's why we say, well, we live in the greatest movie ever in history. And we're the actors of these movies. We're the actors. actors of these movies, and we're living in the greatest movie ever in history, which is seeing a Caucasian wicked-ass bastard get put to death on his last day. And we're gonna see it through the spirit of the Most High God, you know?
Verse 6, like in verse 7, in the multitude of all the nations that fight against Ariel, even all that fight against her and her munition, and that distress her, shall be as a dream of a night vision.
So he said it's going to be as a dream. You fight against Israel, you might as well look for death. You want to fight against the chosen and try to touch the ones that went to the Most High God, you might as well seek death. That's why I eat by jumping on top of the bamboo. Right? Straight missile. Straight to the dead target, immediately. In all praise, you better put it on the TV and everything, man. That was a beautiful thing. Right? Bring it out, bro.
The book of Jeremiah, chapter 5, verse 14. Wherefore thus saith the Lord God of the host, because he speak this word, behold, I will make my words in thy mouth fire.
Make his word what?
My words in thy mouth fire.
So the Lord said the words that God is fire, that's why California is burning right now. As soon as the Most High sent the prophets to bring out this word, all this crazy stuff is starting to happen. Meteors, thunderstrike, earthquakes, storms, fires, forest fires. What's going on? What's your name? What's your name? Huh? Bob? What's your last name? You Caucasian? Huh? You say what? Armenian? Houston, there you go. Healing! There you go. That's what he got to call him, man. At least he knows who he is. You know? You ready to serve the Israelites? No, right? See that? He said no immediately. See that? He said no immediately, but the Lord said it was. Let me drop that. Let me get Isaiah chapter 60, verse 10. All of a sudden, we serving the Caucasian people for more than 400 years. All of a sudden, they don't want to serve us then. Well, we're about to get the king. But let's see what God says, whether you like it or not. Bring it out.
This is the book of Isaiah, chapter 16, verse 10. This is the book of Isaiah, chapter 60 and verse 10. And the sons of strangers shall build up thy wall.
Sons of strangers shall build up thy walls. What the hell, Bob, though? He just left. I mean, he said, oh, no. I mean, how this scripture? He probably said, oh, y'all, I'm about to give it to us. It says, the sons of strangers shall build up thy walls, you know?
And their kings shall minister unto thee. For in my wrath I smote thee. But in my favor have I mercy on thee. Therefore, thy gate shall be open continually.
So the Lord said, our gate's going to be open 24-7. And what's going to happen, you know?
They shall not be shut day nor night.
You know?
That men may bring unto thee the forces of the Gentiles.
The what?
The forces of the Gentiles.
So the Lord is saying all these heathens going to have to serve the children of Israel.
Bring it out.
They can't stop this, man. Any heathen that's trying to go against his word, at the end of the day, you have to serve the children of Israel. Because we have to serve God in this land. This land that Yah took it from the native Seminole Indians and slaughtered so many of them. And got the nerve to make movies to mock them. Got the nerve to make movies like 12 Years a Slave. To mock us. That's why we got all these books, man. We got all these books because what? They got some nerve. 100 years of lynching. 100 years of lynching. And they got some nerve. We're talking about this saved the Lord, the Most High God put vengeance. And just like that car made that noise, the Lord will skid on their neck. The Lord is going to skid on their damn neck. No weapon formed against me shall prosper. The Most High God bring this judgment on this earth. Straight up. 100 years of lynching. And then people got a problem. You got the Caucasian man jumping the damn building. Let more jump, man. Kill them all. Let them all jump, man. That's the least of their worries, man. Because judgment is coming to California. To all America. That's the least of their worries. Right? Now, that'll be a so-called cool. He gonna run up there. No, white daddy, don't do it. Don't do it. Right? Like that movie Django. We sick, boss. This weekend? I don't know, nigga. Man, let him die. Let him die. Because the Lord is going to do what? He's going to separate you from your enemies. Your enemies are going to get the judgment, whether you like it or not. Let me get Proverbs chapter 11, verse 21. Check the scripture here. Come on. Drop that. Let me get Jeremiah chapter 16. They want to talk about a movie and all this stuff and Independence Day and it's damn UFOs and spacecrafts and everything. Yo, think how funny this is now. The American government is showing all the facts about the UFOs. Yeah. Or so-called chariots.
They got a special on Showtime about the
UFOs. Right. And like the same thing. That's why they got that building right there. Ripley's, believe it or not. Guess what? We believe this. Because we know this coming. Where the hell you think they got that movie Independence Day? From the scriptures. They know it's coming. Who the hell need their independence? The children of Israel. We need to be separated from our enemies. Bring it out.
This is the Proverbs, chapter 11 and verse 21. Though hand join in hand, the wicked shall not be unpunished.
So the Lord said the wicked ain't going to be unpunished. You can't try to grab his hand and try to protect him or try to put your freaking body right in front of him and be a shit. The Lord gonna kill your ass too.
That's right.
The blacks and Hispanics, the American guys separate from their enemies because you're going to be. Or the Lord's gonna destroy you and sever your damn ass away from you. Read it again.
Though hand join in hand, the wicked shall not be unpunished.
It says the wicked shall not be unpunished. We're just coming out here to tell y'all the truth. Because what? Y'all celebrities, your buildings, all the mayors, all the presidents, they're all going down.
That's right!
They're all going down. And we had a watch. We want to see every single wicked demon get put to death with us, faith the Lord.
Right.
We had a watch. We don't care about no damn those movies or that. No, we living in the movie. And we want to watch our enemy get destroyed. Right. Bring it out.
Bring that out.
Jeremiah 16 and 19.
Bring it out.
Verse 14. Therefore, behold, the day is short, saith the Lord. So no more be said. The Lord liveth that while the children of Israel are out of the land of Egypt.
Well, it says, a day's gonna come. No more they're gonna speak about the children of Israel coming out of Egypt. No more they're gonna speak about the Ten Commandments and have a Moses as a dead white man at the damn top of the mountain talking about, thou shalt not pass. No more that garbage.
Right.
We're speaking about the truth of the so called black people. Yeah. And it wasn't no damn Ten Commandments. It was 613 laws for the children of Israel only. Only. Right? Hold that. Let me get Psalms chapter 147, verse 19. So the Most High said, no one's going to speak about what happened in Egypt. Why? Because it's going to be the greatest story ever written in history. It's going to be the greatest movie ever written in history. And the producer of the movie is who? The Most High. None of that Caucasian man. None of Steven Spielberg. No, the producer of the movie is Yahweh Shalom.
That's right.
And the characters in the movie? So lock it. The character, right? The characters in the movie is going to be... Now you like to say Bill Cosby, right? Now Bill Cosby is free.
That's right.
But guess who's getting locked up? Guess what? What was that? The producer? Huh? The producer that got locked up, that started the Me Too movement. Weinstein. Right?
Harvey Weinstein.
Right. Harvey Davidson. Harvey Weinstein got himself in the jail. He got to run it down now in the prison cell while they turn his behind up. Right? But with Bill Cosby, the real deal Bill, right there, Come on, man. Bill Cosby, when they ran on the man, and they said that what? They said that he raped more than 50 white women. Nigga, you crazy? The white woman loved Bill Cosby because he was a so-called what? Father of America. They loved him. But the problem with Bill Cosby was he tried to buy NBC. He tried to buy NBC, and guess who had NBC? The Caucasian man. So all of a sudden, he tried to get that money, and they said, No, Mr. Bill Cosby. He tried to buy NBC, but guess who still got their network? Oprah. Why is it Oprah still got her network? Because she already sold out. She sold out. So what Oprah does is what? When she got her network, guess what happened that week? Her best friend, Harvey Weinstein, her best friend,
right?
She had to protect him. So she put him in the back page and started bringing out who in the front page? R. Kelly and Michael Jackson. right? She threw all her mother into the bus. But Mr. Harvey Weinstein, the damn predator or pedophile, she was protected. That's why the Lord says, though, here join the hand, the wicked shall not be punished. So Oprah can have a damn network, and her network is called what? Oxygen. But she don't got the breath of life. So the Most High is gonna snatch her damn.
That's right.
Right? Bring it out.
What?
It's owned? Yeah, she being, yeah, she's being owned by the Caucasian man. That's what's going on. She's being owned by the devil. Yeah. She's gonna have her own network in her own brain right next to the Caucasian man. Bring it out.
Thus, Book of Jeremiah 45, verse 4. Thus shall thou say unto him, the Lord saith thus, behold that which I have built, will I break down? Jeremiah 16, 14. Therefore, behold, the days come, saith the Lord, that it shall be, that it shall no more be said, the Lord liveth, that brought up the children of Israel out of the land of Egypt.
But we're not going to be speaking about what happened in Egypt now. We're in Egypt today. How we prove that? Bring it out.
This is the book of Revelation, chapter 11 and verse 8. And their dead bodies shall lie in the street of the great city, which is spiritually called Sodom and Egypt.
So this place that is called America is spiritually called Sodom and Egypt. And our dead bodies have been lying all over the streets, man. Getting attacked by the Caucasian people, by the police officers. Getting shot down, getting lynched, rape, rob, and murder. That's why this book is called 100 Years of Lynching. We're being slaughtered by the hands of our enemies. That's why Miss Sally Mae just walked up. Alright? Just walked up. All these devils looking around, they think this is a big show. No, this is not no show. This is us prophesying the death and destruction of these wicked bastards. We had to see the fall of our enemies. Because they have done the same to us. So it says their dead bodies shall lie in the street, which is called spiritually Sodom and Egypt. Why is it called Sodom, first of all? For homosexuality. Homosexuality, man. Sodomites. Running rampant like a bunch of wicked bastards, man. They ain't gonna know right there. You can't make this up, man. And we can't, and guess what? We try to say something against them, we might lose our job. But you know what's funny about being a prophet of the Lord? You can't lose this job.
That's right.
If you speak against wickedness, you're going to keep your job. But if you speak for evil and want to be a partaker of the evil, wicked-ass society, the Lord will fight your ass immediately. And literally. That's what the Most High is going to do. And that's why we tell our people, look at that. We got to tell our people, y'all got to repent. Y'all got to repent, man. This is the land of filthiness and darkness, man. And we ain't trying to come up out of here to be our life. Bring it out.
Where also our Lord was crucified.
Where the Most High sent his son Yahushua, and how is he being crucified? Because we're his representation today. How the hell is Christ being crucified? Look at this right here. That's how the hell Christ is being crucified. Look at this. They got the so-called greatest black man ever walked on the face of the earth, and they make him look like this guy. Like Mr. Fabio.
That's right.
You might as well put him in a damn, I can't believe this motherfucker. Commercial. Looking like this. Right? And you think Christ is going to come back and be like, oh my God, I'm going to hug you up. I love you, I love you. He ain't doing none of that. He comes back with a sworn invention. With a sworn invention, because what? This place don't deserve that judgment. Drop that. Let me get 2 Corinthians chapter 13. Give us what's on the Father too. This is the book of wisdom of Solomon, chapter 5, verse 2. When they see it, they shall be troubled with terrible fear, and shall be amazed.
Be what?
And shall be amazed. Why are the people going to be amazed? Because in a place where they show chariots or so-called UFOs, and 10 years ago, y'all would have said he was conspiracy theorists. But now America's already showing it right now. The chariots of God is already here. Y'all can't stop this. Y'all living in the book. Bring it out.
This is the book of 2 Esdras, chapter 13, verse 1. And it came to pass after 7 days, I dreamed a dream by night. And lo, there arose a wind from the sea, that it moved all the waters thereof. And I beheld, and lo, that man waxed strong.
It says what?
That man wax strong.
He said that man wax strong. That's before Christ. You think this man look like he can wax strong? You think this person look mighty right here?
Nope.
You think he like to kill billions of people with his bare hands? This man can't do that. But he gonna try to hug billions of people with his hands. Say, I love you all. But yeah, like the brother was saying, the kid did. But guess what? You can't bear this burden when the Most High put this damn cherry on America's neck. Now you ain't gonna bear this burden. Why? Because destruction is coming. We are.
The man waxed strong with thousands of heavens.
With the what?
With thousands of heavens.
It said Christ came with the thousands of heavens. That's the angels that he's coming with, that America wanted to portray as the aliens or the UFOs. This is in the Bible. Right? That's why they had that movie Independence Day. When that big ass ship came through and blasted the White House. What do you think will happen? This is in the Bible, you know?
And when he turned his countenance to look, all the things trembled that were seen under him. And whatsoever the voice went out of his mouth, all they burned that heard his voice.
And that's the ships, that's the chariots. When they had them blast, and many people just got wiped out, turned to dust. This is in the Bible. This is where all these so-called producers get their book from, or their story from. Or their movies from the Holy Bible.
That's right.
And guess what? The Bible is manifested right in front of everybody else. Y'all worry about your favorite actors, your favorite celebrities, LeBron James or Kobe Bryant, whatever, all these people. No, they gotta worry about y'all keeping y'all salvation right now. This is the last quarter. You got Jake worrying about the damn NBA finals. Right? Nigga, you in the finals.
Hey!
This is the last quarter, man. You talking about the last 5 seconds. Nigga, you gotta repent. Because when the law comes, there's no retries. This is it. Are you gonna get the ball and he's just gonna pass the ball, which is you passing your salvation? No, you gotta repent. Ain't no overtime, man. That's why we doing overtime right now. Putting the work in the road right now. Yeah.
Like as the earth filleth, when it filleth the fire.
When the earth filleth the what?
When it filleth the fire.
You think it's hot right now in California? The Most High is going to bring these chariots and we're going to bring fire to this earth.
That's what?
This earth is going to be done. Quick, fast, in a hurry.
1 hour.
Like 1 hour, like the brother was saying. You guys, the white man that did moves. Breaking news, ladies and gentlemen. America's burning. Oh my God. Oh my God.
Hug your kids.
Hug your kids. Hug your wife and kids. Right? I never thought this was happening. Cracking down tears and everything, man. And the Most High was like, aha!
Good!
Gotcha, sucker. Good. Bring it out!
God. Verse 5. And after this I beheld, and lo, there were gathered together a multitude of men, out of number, from the four winds of heaven.
That's speaking about the whole world. It's going to try to come and try to fight against Christ. But think about it. Why is in the church, they'll tell you that Christ said he loves everybody. God loves everybody. But in this Bible, this scripture says, the whole world from the four corners of heaven, of the whole earth is going to come together. You know?
To subdue the man.
To do what?
To subdue the man.
And that's the so-called white man. Whenever you see a so-called black man in power, now white men feel threatened now. They gotta come out like they did with the Black Panthers. When brothers start to get together and try to fight against the system, now they come in with the CIA and infiltrate the Black Panthers. Infiltrate all these organizations that's trying to help their people. But guess what? You can't come against this.
That's right.
You can't stop this, because this is of the Most High God. This is of the Lord, this is the truth for the Most High. And the Lord said, well, we're going to be a spectacle to all men. So everybody going to see what's happening. Everybody going to see the rise of the 12 tribes of Israel right in front of their eyes. And they can't stop this. Drop that. Let me get Isaiah chapter 19 and verse 1. What scripture you got? Right? Isaiah chapter 19 and verse 1. Come. Bring it up.
This is the book of Isaiah chapter 19 and verse 1. The burden of Egypt.
You know what I'm saying?
The burden of Egypt.
This is a burden of Egypt. We're not speaking about the one in North Africa. We're speaking about here, America. Egypt is America right now. Because of wickedness and oppression. Who have you oppressed? Who has the American system oppressed? The blacks and Hispanics stay American for more than 400 years. So now, it becomes a burden because the children of God is in the hands of the white man. And he can't stop the judgment of the Lord.
Right.
Everything you have done to us, the Most High is going to bring back upon you double. And we're going to watch every single judgment going on your wicked ass.
Right.
You know what?
The burden of Egypt, behold, Yahweh riding upon a swift cloud.
On a what?
A swift cloud.
I'm speaking about the chariots. A swift cloud. Them chariots is here for your destruction. You know?
It shall come into Egypt. And the idols of Egypt shall be.
And the what?
And the idols of Egypt.
And the what?
And the idols of Egypt.
What about these so-called Hollywood celebrities?
And the idols of Egypt.
It says